Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is actually the rack mount kit for the Ubiquiti Pro-Max 16 PoE. So if you've not seen that already, this is the device. It's slightly too thin to be able to fit on a rack, but it also comes with an external power pack, which means it's not ideal straight away in that setup to be able to rack mount it. So Ubiquiti have brought out a rack mount kit, which I'll show you. It's not going to be a big technical overview, but I will show you how it all fits together. So you are going to get a packet that's got your rack mount screws, brackets for the back, and screws to be able to fit all of the rest of the pieces together. You are going to get two portions of the actual rack mount, depending on which way you're going to put it round. Hang on, let's make it which way it's going to go round. That'll be like that, wouldn't it? Or the other way. I'll show you how that fits together in a moment. You are going to get the back box for it, that the power supply and everything's going to sit in, and you're going to get the plastic lid for it as well. So let me show you maybe how this all fits together. So we first got our big mains power pack. Let me grab that here. The idea with this is that obviously I can conceal pretty much all of this, and then it's going to turn into a rack mount kit with it. So let's take first our power pack. Our power pack is going to mount into the back of this box like this. All right, should neatly clip into place. You can see that it's clipped in. We've then got some clips around the front here that we can tidy up some of our cable for, and it will depend on which side you're actually going to run this out to, because in the back of the switch here is the in, and it obviously depends whether you're going to mount this on this side or mount it on the other side. I've actually done it on the other side, so I need my biggest long length of cable to come out that way. So I'm just going to tidy a little bit away into this case here so that you can actually see how it all works. All right, let me go for there, I think. And then you've got a channel down the edge here that I can actually run the cable down the edge and out of the hole there. So let me just tidy that in there so you can see. It is a little fiddly, but obviously you're only going to do this once. All right, so it is there now tidied, and I can now take the lid and I can clip the lid into place there. I do have options if I want to, because I've actually mounted this the wrong way around for mine, to actually bring the cable down the other side. Just having a look at how I need to do mine here. So let me just take the cable out and run it now down the other side here, again in that channel. So you can obviously make this a left or a right mount, depending on probably where your power cable is coming in, whatever way suits you the most. So let me just bring that into place inside there and tidy it in. All right, so now it's in place. Now I can bring my lid in, clip it into place, and clip that shut. Now my power pack and everything, obviously my IEC in, probably missed that hole at the back there. Look at me do it in the speed of trying to do this. Let's try that, open it up again. Just push that in because I've missed it. All right, so there we go, our IEC in, our cable out. Now we need to be able to connect that to our unit itself. So you'll have actually seen, hopefully they'll just show up under the light. You have four of these, one, two on either side. You actually got a tool when you bought your USW Pro Max 16 there, that was to actually flick those brackets out. And once they're flicked out, they're exposed like this on the side. So we're gonna take our switch, which is this way round, and we have basically our L bracket. So we figure out which side our L bracket is going to go, and we can actually then screw that with the screws in the packet there to the side of the device. And obviously now we've got our first fitted bracket on that side, and we can then use our other one to flip one of these out from here, and that's going to allow us to mount. What we can then do, once we've done that, I'll show you without the unit in place because it's probably easier just thinking about which way it's going to be round. I can actually take my box. You'll see it's got these clips on the side. This bracket here has also got pins at the front, and basically I can connect that, probably best way to see it, the pins line up, and I actually push that into place. All right, and that's now solidly in place. So if that had already been screwed to the side, then I would have just pushed my box in and I would have now got my fittings in place. And obviously then all I would have done is, if I just try and reverse the whole thing round for you, hopefully, and put these together as if they had been screwed together. Let's see if I can make that happen here. There we go, almost there, like that. Then I obviously could have run my power cable out here and plugged it into the back of the unit. And that would have been my sort of L shape. It's a little bit convoluted, but that's our now our rack mount from the back with our power in over this side. All right, and obviously all neatened up at the front. So hopefully it gives you an idea of what's in the box and how it all fits together for the rack mount there for the USW-Pro-Max-16. Head on over to our YouTube channel. Got plenty more box openings on network firewall, wireless, camera security, plenty of how-to guides, how to set up Unify Network, for instance. So why don't you go there, subscribe, and stay up to date.